Good evening. Hello. Welcome to our 7th annual Christmas in Elmhurst concert. We began this tradition back in 2015. We took a year off for COVID, and we are back. It's good to be back. Now, let me ask you a couple questions. How many of you here, with a show of hands, have been to one of these Christmas in Elmhurst concerts before? Can I see your hand? Wow, great. Welcome back. And how many are attending one of these concerts for the first time tonight? Wow, a lot of hands. Thank you. Thank you for coming. And how many of you attended last night's concert? Can I see your hand? Yeah, okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. One more question. How many of you here, show of hands, have attended all 7 concerts? Wow, a few of you. Well, you guys qualify for something special tonight. You qualify for double cookies in refreshment time afterwards, and a picture with Dennis Kreiser, our conductor extraordinaire. So, thank you for that. My name is Jim Lennon, and I'm the pastor of West Suburban Community Church in Elmhurst. It's our privilege to sponsor the concert every year, along with others who support us from the community. Those singing in the choir we have here are from 10 different local churches in Elmhurst and around the surrounding area. And in addition, those playing in the orchestra are also from area churches around the area, and we also have some students from Wheaton College playing in the orchestra tonight. So we thank them for coming and being here and helping us. We are very glad you're here tonight and hope you enjoy the concert as we focus tonight on the birth of Jesus Christ. Thank you.
Thank you. As you can see, we have some younger singers coming to join us on the stage. This year, we're privileged again to have a children's choir with us for this particular song. And also, towards the end of the concert, we'll bring them back. But don't they look good up there, kids? Thank you for joining us tonight. Choir is going to go down also at this point. We'll give them just a little breather and want to let you have an opportunity to do some singing tonight as well. So we're going to do a medley of carols that you're welcome to sing along with. How many of you love to sing Christmas carols? Anybody out there? Does anybody hate to sing Christmas carols? Anybody there? You can hum if you want to. You can hum. You don't have to sing. The audience last night, I could not believe the volume that they were singing with. So we'll see if you can match that tonight or not. Eric is going to come and lead us in these carols. And why don't you stand together if you'd like, stretch your legs, and we'll have some fun. Have you sung those carols before? It's beautiful, beautiful. I think you were either equal to last night or better. Yeah. Love to hear your voices singing the praises of God. Do those carols. Thank you.
Thank you. you know what? Nothing says Christmas like a knock-knock joke. Can you folks help me out tonight? Knock-knock. Needle. Need a little cash for some Christmas presents. Knock-knock. Irish. Irish you a Merry Christmas. True story, four-year-old Caleb decided he had the absolute best knock-knock joke for his three-year-old sister, Lucy. Went like this. Knock-knock. Knock-knock. Folks, you're a little slow. Let's pick it up. Knock-knock. 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 All right, finally, just like you, Lucy had had enough. And she spins on her heel and says, "No more chances," and walks out of the room. Anybody ever said that to you? Maybe it was a boss that you really didn't like anyway and walked into your office one afternoon and said, "No more chances. You're out of a job." Maybe it was an adult child that said to you one day, "No more chances," and you rarely even see them. Perhaps for you it was a boyfriend or girlfriend, a husband, a wife. No more chances. And they've walked out of your life. Wow. But what's the problem behind all these problems? The Bible word is sin. It's falling short of God's standard. It's the me monster lifestyle we all fall into. The Bible says your sins have separated you from your God. We're on the outside looking in. I think of four-year-old Ava. Her winter coat was a giant ball of fur and sleeves and things where they shouldn't be. And she was trying to put that thing on with no luck at all. And finally she says to me, "Could you please turn my outside inside?" That's exactly what Jesus came to do. Born at Christmas, crucified at Easter, Jesus came to make forgiveness and eternal life possible. But you don't get it automatically. It's not about being good enough, going to church enough, saying the right things, giving enough money. No, the Bible says it's by grace that we're saved through faith. But faith in what? Religious vagaries? No. The Bible says if you will confess with your mouth, that means agree. Confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. In other words, he'll turn your outside inside. Knock, knock. Jesus. Jesus Christ, who says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in." Isn't that what you want? Why don't you let him in right now? We're going to pray together silently. I'll give you space to pray along with me. Lord God of heaven, I'm a sinner. Would you please forgive me, Lord? Would you help me turn away from this selfish living, this sinning? And would you be my Savior, in charge of me from this day forward? In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, if you just prayed that prayer, we'd love to meet you afterwards. Pastor Dennis is glad to talk with you. Pastor Jim Lennon, you met earlier. He may be taking photographs of Pastor Dennis with so many people. Love to talk with you after the concert. But right now, we've got two more numbers.
Thank you so much for being here tonight. It's been a joy to be with you, a pleasure. The evening's not over, though, because there are tons of Christmas cookies down the hall, and they're in the commons area, if you're familiar with the school. If you're not familiar, you just walk out the back door, take a left, you'll go through some double doors, and just keep walking. The choir is actually going to go out and line the hallway so you can kind of follow down there. Christmas cookies, coffee, apple juice, apple cider, and best of all, bottled water is down there as well. So we invite you to join us. We'd love to meet you there. And one other thing, on your program, if you turn that program over, you'll see a white square kind of in the middle. And there are two events that are listed there over at West Suburban Community Church. If you do not have a church home that you go to regularly, we would love for you to join us. First of all, on Christmas Eve, it's 5 o'clock, and there is a chalk drawing presentation and singing of carols. It'll be a great time of celebrating the birth of Christ. And then Christmas Day, what day of the week is Christmas on this year? Sunday. So we're going to have a 10 o'clock Sunday service celebrating the birth of Christ. And if you don't have a church home, we would love to see you there and celebrate together. The orchestra is going to play one more song. The choir has already left us. They're out in the hall, kind of lining the way down to the cookies. So out and to the left.